than a prison guard son. I don't need to be anything other than a specialist son. I don't have to be anyone other than a birth of two souls in one. Part of where I'm going, it's nowhere where I'm coming from. I don't wanna be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is think of me and I have peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around the room wondering what I gotta do or who I'm supposed to be.
Good afternoon, Irving High School. I'm Carolina.
And I'm JC, here with your Kirv Midday Report. Today is April 14th, 2014.
Seniors, continue to send your pictures for the senior breakfast video. If you want to be shown in the video, send your pictures to irvingseniors14@gmail.com. The deadline has been changed to this Friday, so get your pictures in ASAP. Juniors, listen up. The next few announcements are for you.
Those of you who have registered for dual credit classes for next year, your Northlake application and the pre-assessment is due April 18th. If you need help with the online process, the counselors are available in the counseling office tomorrow during all lunches, Wednesday, April 16th before and after school, and Friday, April 18th during all lunches.
Also, juniors, you're taking the SAT on Wednesday. Testing will be taken upstairs in rooms 201 through 235. You must be at school no later than 7:45. Begin now to start making arrangements to be at school at 7:45. And don't forget to bring your admission ticket, your school ID, a calculator which you can get from your math teachers, pencils, and snacks for your breaks. Good luck to all you juniors on Wednesday.
Your class shirts are in. If you ordered a t-shirt, go see Mr. Galanis in room 417 to pick them up before or after school.
Those of you interested in trying out for Tiger Fever and Tiger Guard for the 2014-2015 school year will need to attend a mandatory parent meeting on April 22nd at 5:30 p.m. in the cafeteria. Trials will be held on May 1st. You must have passed all your classes in the 4-6 weeks in order to try out. Please see Coach Keith if you have any more questions.
And lastly, juniors, if you missed the Kirv informational meeting last Friday, stop by Mrs. Lobb's room today right after school to talk to her.
Seniors, check your student email today for more info about the senior DVD. Your participation is key in this video, so if you're interested in being in the DVD, then email us today.
There is an event going on this Friday, April 18th, in the library celebrating National Poetry and Reading Month. If you're interested in attending, see Mrs. Farrell in the library or talk to your English teacher for more info.
Students and teachers, there are three seniors who need your help. Kenny Nguyen and Delilah Moreno are both trying to win scholarships for college, and Adrian Sanchez is competing for a chance to perform at Earth Day Texas with the Texas Music Project. All three links will be in the Kirv Twitter account, which is at KIRV Broadcast. So retweet and vote for Kenny, Adrian, and Delilah.
If you are still planning on participating in the annual Culture Fair on April 29th, then you better sign up quick. Countries are being claimed left and right, but there are still some great countries left to choose from, such as Spain, Italy, Vietnam, El Salvador, and so much more. Stop by Mr. Newman's room 227 to sign up.
Students, don't forget to keep donating for Pasta for Pennies during all three lunches. Remember, the fourth period that collects the most money wins a free Olive Garden lunch. Our goal is to raise $2,000 for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Association, and the last day to donate is this Wednesday.
This past week, 10 IHS students traveled to Corpus Christi to compete in the FCCLA State Leadership Conference. Two teams placed in the top six, which was Myra Guevara and Joanna Artigo, who got third place for Chapter and Review, and Sandra Valenzuela and Guadalupe Hernandez, who placed fourth in Live Event Planning. Congrats to FCCLA for their hard work and dedication to the team. And this is their little award.
And lastly, this announcement is for everyone who's involved in dance class. Tomorrow, all dance students must be in the auditorium from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Y'all allowed to go to tutoring if needed at 4:15 or get something to eat, but you must be back by 5:30. And this Thursday is the day of the concert. All dance students must be in the auditorium from 5:30 until showtime. Again, you may go to tutoring at 4:15 or get something to eat, but be sure to be back at school before 5:30. The show is free and will be from 7 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. in the auditorium.
That concludes our news for you today. I'm JC.
And I'm Carolina. Now over to Freddie McKenzie for your Tiger Sports update.
Tiger Sports update today.
To start off our news today, here are the results from District 6-5A golf tournament held at Bird Creek Golf Course. Boys on April 2nd and 3rd of 56 entries, and girls on April 7th and 8th.
Corey Miller shot a 97 with 88 with a score of 185. Kaylee Bartlett shot a 135 and 129 with a score of 264. Ryan Cerosi shot a 113 and a 107 with a score of 220. Victoria Cruz shot a 138 and a 132 with a score of 270. And Angelica Navarez shot a 142 and a 131 with a score of 273.
Way to go. Our softball girls took on Arl Turner at home this past Friday and run ruled them after the third inning 15-0. They take on those Trinity Trojans tomorrow over at their house starting at 7:15. Be there as it starts their final week of district games.
The Irving Gymnastics team had a great showing Wednesday and Thursday at the regional competition. Ruby Bayo and Emily Shear did a great job on the beam, while Daisy Couillard had a personal best on the uneven bar.
On the men's side, Jaquavin Williams had personal best on floor exercise and vault, and Dennis Garcia performed a T-vault for the first time and finished in the top 15. Way to go, Gymnastics!
Our varsity baseball team plays Colleyville Heritage tomorrow at Heritage starting at 7.
And track has an aerial meet that is in Coppell on Thursday.
This weekend, our Pollard Polo team has a regional tourney, so good luck to them.
And JV1 baseball is at Colleyville tonight starting at 6, and JV2 baseball plays Colleyville here tonight also starting at 6. So go out and support our boys.
Well, that concludes our news for today. I'm McKenzie.
And I'm Freddie. Make it a great day, everyone.